G'day mates, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, we have a lot to talk about. We had the first look at the late game cup game mode and it looks amazing. It was an absolutely fantastic tournament. We had stacked games, active storm surge. There's a few things I would change with the game mode and a few slight criticisms I have that I want to talk about, but overall, I absolutely love this game mode and I'm so happy it's back. We also have the details on our first console exclusive tournament of the season. I'm going to go through all that, how you can enter, how you can play, my thoughts on console exclusive tournaments as well. And at the end of today's video, I want to round it all out by talking about the changes to how the cash cups are going to work at the start of this season. How many points do you need? Do you need to be in champs and everything else that you might be wondering? So let's just jump into it. Just quickly, before we jump into today's video, I want to give a huge shout out to today's sponsor, G2A. I've worked with them for a while now. You guys absolutely love them, but in case you haven't heard about them, G2A.com is an online marketplace where you can buy almost anything you can think of. But the reason why I've been using them for so long and I always recommend them to you guys is their prices on games. If you're looking to buy a new game, go to G2A.com, search it up. You could be saving so, so much money. They have almost every title from really, really old retro games, right up to the new releases. I myself recently have been getting into Battlefield ahead of Battlefield 2042. I needed to repurchase Battlefield 4. I found it online for 70% off at G2A, scrolled through their seller list, found someone that I trusted, bought it through them, got sent the key and downloaded it, and it was just that simple. I want to pass the savings on to you. Stop paying too much for games. Go through G2A.com. If you guys somehow missed it, we had the solo late game cup today in Fortnite for all the major regions. It was our first proper look at the late game cup remake because we had it for the Booger game mode, but they said they were going to make some changes. The zone was going to be better. The loot was going to better fit the current competitive pool. And honestly, I have to say, they were right. This game mode is amazing. It was already amazing. The Booger game mode was so much fun. All of us were so upset when they took it out and we finally have it back and it's even better. There's still a few issues that I want to talk about, but overall, this game mode may be one of the greatest additions to Fortnite ever. And I genuinely believe that. And I think the community does too. Not just the amount of people participating in the tournaments and playing in it, but how good the games were. Today for solos, we had no prize money on the line, both NA East and EU. I went back in the EU VODs and I've watched all of NA East live on my Twitch channel. They had active storm surge in pretty much every game in round two and even some of the games in round one for zero prize money in a solos tournament. Like, that already tells you more than anything you need to know about how good this game is. I absolutely love it. I'm actually hoping when the game mode comes out properly, it stays for forever. I want this to be like a team rumble. There is no reason why it should go away. It's so much fun. It's good for competitive and it's good for practice and it's a great, great way for people who are new to Fortnite to get into end game practice to then get into tournaments. Because previously, the only practice we had was like end game scrims, which, let's be honest, are pretty terrible for the most part. I've never been a huge fan of them. A lot of people get led down this path of thinking they understand how the game works. They know how to play endgame. They're really good. But when you play in a game mode where no one's allowed to fight, so you can literally build a giant 5x5 metal base in center zone, go refarm your mats, bring them back in. Like, it's just not realistic. This might not be super realistic, but I think it's pretty close. I honestly think it's as close as we're going to get. So let's talk about the changes they made. First off, they said they fixed the zones. Now, this is the first and probably only negative I'm going to have. Yes, they have fixed zones. They do act like normal zones in Fortnite if every single zone pulled max. Pretty much the zones almost always go max, max on max on max. What do I mean by max? On rotating zones, there's a certain distance that a zone can pull and it has a maximum distance it can go. Sometimes in real games, it's less than that. In this game mode, it's almost always max. And once it goes max once, it goes max again. So you probably have the feeling the zones are faster than regular zones. They're actually not. We've had word from Epic. They are the exact same speed of normal zones, but they're the same speed of normal zones when they go max constantly. And that almost never happens in a game. You almost never see zones just keep pulling that far constantly. So other than that though, it's pretty amazing. Now, the loot pool. They said there is 9 loot pool choices for solos. That's why I got to check out today. For trios tomorrow, we'll check out what trios looks like. But they're really good. One major complaint I keep hearing a lot is there's not enough shield. And I kind of like this. So a lot of the loot choices, one that I keep seeing, for example, is a burst. You have a purple AUG. You have, I believe, a green pump. You have a purple rapid fire SMG or blue rapid fire SMG. I think 3 minis and a big pot. Now, That's not a lot of shield. In a lot of tournaments, you'll probably go into endgame with more shield than that, usually a full stack of minis, maybe four at the very least if you're stacked, and usually two big pots. So you do have less shield than what you would have, but hey, I think that's still fair. Not every game you go in super stacked, but I think that's a very deliberate choice from Epic, and I like it. It means that you can't W key as heavily. Teams will and players will still W key early, but all it takes is you to try to fight someone. They're a good player. They hit you for like 100. You hit them for 100. You pop two of your three minis and one big pot. You now have one mini left. So you now have to either key that player and kill them, but they probably use the shields because you hit them, and now you have nothing to show for it. And I think players started to figure this out early on because the games obviously were skill-based matchmaking. They started to get better, but overall the games, in my opinion, started to get more stacked because people were realizing they couldn't just straight up W key the first person next to them. Also, there is a bit of lag. The server lag is... it's pretty realistic to an endgame, I'm not gonna lie. There are some moments where it's really bad, where it's like straight up stuttering, and you know, that's obviously a bit of a glitch. But overall, the lag feels pretty realistically close to a good endgame, but the lag is at the start, when you don't wanna be fighting anyway. So honestly, I really think they've done an almost perfect job so far. Fix up the zones a little bit so they don't constantly go to max distance, but the loadouts are good. I think the scoring system was really good, and overall, I think it was probably one of the most fun tournaments I've ever watched and seen players have fun in solos. I think it's fair to say that this was the best solo tournament I've almost ever watched, and there was no money on the line. I also want to talk to that. A lot of people asking, why is there no prize money? Why are we doing this for nothing? I think this is a test. That's why they had it before the actual game releases. If you guys didn't read the blog post they put out, the actual game mode is going to come out on the 5th. There will be a solos and trios option with fills, so you can play the trio fills, make some friends, just like arena fills we had. But I think this was a little bit of a test to see solos and trios before they put money into it, because in the blog post, they very specifically stated there are going to be more tournaments running on this game mode. So look out for those, but right now, hey, late game is phenomenal and Epic, congratulations, you put in a phenomenal addition to the game. Can't give you enough props and credits. This is one of the things that I think will save Fortnite or will keep it going for a long period of time. Just please, please do not take it out. There is no reason to. Maybe the smaller regions, it could cause some issues with arena queues. So maybe like OC, they're already doing, maybe you can turn it off at night when it's really, really bad queue times. Again, I'd rather that not happen, but if you have to. But hey, regions like EU, NA East, the bigger regions, they could easily facilitate having this end arena. There's no reason to take it out. Please, Epic, do not take this away from us. Because there was no prize money, I haven't been focusing on it too much, as in like who did really well, who did really bad. I might talk about that in future with the prize money, but hey, big shout out to who did well, because the games were tough and the games were stacked. We had none other than OCE's Muzz coming in first on NA East, Skittles in second, Statics, Owl, who was absolutely popping off. I don't know, I was watching Owl play today, man, and I have a feeling it's looking a bit like Owl season. My man is looking pretty crazy. Obviously, Muzz winning it out, looking nuts as well, but I think Owl's been kind of flying under the radar for a while now, and he's coming in real, real hot right now. We have Okus, we have Archive, Playify, Berserk, Alige, HyperX, TK just outside top 10. Going over to EU, we had the Asia FNCS winner, now come EU competitor Force, getting 556, insane performance from him. We had Malabuka in second, Cade in third, we had Wixic in fourth, we had Lives, I can't pronounce that one, I'm sorry, Noel Riley, we had Fishy, we had Fixsteel, Luca, Lunex, we had Sangil just outside top 10. So we had some big names you'd expect to see up there. Man, the end games were fun to watch. Like, these were really, really fun games to watch. If you guys want to watch how trios play out, I will be doing a viewing party only of NA East. I'll do EU in the future if there's money on the line, but I don't really want to wake up at 2 a.m. for no money. So if you want to watch how trios goes, twitch.tv/AussieAntics. I'll be doing a viewing party of all the NA East games today as of this video going live. Now, we have our first console exclusive tournament of Season 8. We have the Fortnite PlayStation Cup taking place today as of this video going live. It is, of course, based on the name, exclusive to PS4 and PS5. Now, it has a prize pool of $113,400. Now, I wanted to give my thoughts on this. First off, very, very happy with a lot of things they've done with this tournament. Firstly, they split the prize pool very, very thin. I've talked about this a lot. When you have a prize pool for console, whatever it is, you can debate debate about as much as you want. I think console deserve their own tournaments or their own prize pool. I've explained this a lot in the past. Whether you think it's competitive or not, I think for the longevity of the game and keeping the community playing, I think console cups are vital for the community. So I'm excited to see them add one, but I've always talked about how they should spread the prize money more thin. Don't have first place walk away with a ridiculous amount and it only goes till top five, because what you're going to have is a bunch of PC pros picking up a console, playing it and getting a huge chunk of the money, which again, they're playing on the same input. So I think it's fair that they place and I respect it. But I think if you're really doing what these console tournaments should be for, in my opinion, which is giving back to the console community who's funding the game and spending so much money and supporting it, you should spread the prize money more thin. It means that pros can still come play on a console if they want to. And if they place, congratulations, that's awesome to them. No hate to them. But I think it will incentivize pros to only come to console if they truly want to place and if they are good on console and they're actually, like, you know, at least somewhat part of the console scene, rather than just, you know, not playing in a PC tournament because there's a console tournament on where first place gets 10 grand. That's what you see. If you look at EU, NA East, NA West, and Brazil, the top four major regions, first gets 1200 and 64th gets 200. That's a pretty wide split. They could have easily made first like 5,000 and then not worried about those 51st to 64th places. You know what I mean? Like, when you think about giving 200 to an extra 15 people playing, essentially, that's $3,000. That's what I mean by spreading it thin. And I know not everyone agrees with me on that point. Like, that's fine. I get it. I understand that when it's a tournament, you want it to be competitive. But I think by virtue, Fortnite isn't a truly competitive game. It never has, it never will be. And I think that's why it's such a great game. Anyone can show up on the day, play from home, and they can earn money. That's why there's always going to be issues of teaming. There's always going to be issues of cheating. But that's what makes Fortnite so great. You don't have to join an org and go through all this qualification process. So what I describe when I talk about console tournaments, I know it's not technically competitive, but I'm not trying to say it is. I'm trying to say what I think is best for the console scene and therefore best for Fortnite for the long term going forward. I'm not saying give them 80% of the prize pool. I'm just saying when you see tournaments like this, I think it's great to see them spread more thin. Obviously, next topic, it's only PlayStation exclusive. That is a little bit sad. The one thing that scares me about this is I was really happy to see in the blog post that Epic saying there is going to be console-specific tournaments this season outside of just the Console Champions Cup. I hope this isn't what they're referring to, because this is awesome. This is fantastic. But this should be a bonus on top of a tournament that Epic is putting on. I know the Console Champions Cup is on, but I do think there should be more regular tournaments for console just with a smaller prize pool. Even, like, I've asked you guys in the comments so many times. You guys always have the same opinion. Aussie, even if Epic gave us next to no prize pool, just a tournament that I can play in that I know I'm versing only console players so I can really test my skill and see how I go. And I love that. And I think that should happen. So I really hope this isn't what Epic was talking about. I hope this is like a bonus on top of what Epic has planned, but really awesome to see. Obviously, you know, a lot of PC players are still picking up PlayStation 4s and 5s and giving it a go, but I think that's still good because there's still a lot of prize money to be earned and majority of it is going to go to truly, truly console players. It also has a set lobby finals. So the way it'll work is top 100 players are going to advance through into round two in every single region. So it's going to be set lobby finals with six games. As far as who can play in it, I can't see any requirement. It doesn't look like you need to be Contenders League. It doesn't look like you need to be Champs League. It looks like literally anyone can play in this. And the point format's pretty good. Vic Rory gets 30 points and each Elim gets one. In round two, the Elims are worth two. So really a competitive format with a great prize pool, and it's for console. I'm really, really excited to see it. Also, just wanted to throw this in here, as I know you guys are going to ask, the tournament is not region locked. As far as I can see from the rules, the clause about region lock is not in there. Every single other tournament where that has been the case, it has not been region locked. Just make sure, just check Fortnite's competitive Twitter, maybe check my stream if you want to come in and check with me. But until then, nothing has changed at this point. It looks like you can play multiple regions. So you can play on any one that you want or as many as you can. Just obviously look, round one and round two are clash for a lot of them. So just make sure that whatever region you care about most, you're ready to play round one for that region. In case you guys missed it as well, we had confirmation of something that I was suspicious about. You do not need to be in Champions League for this week's Cash Cups for solos and trios. You need to be in Contenders League, which is 1,500 points. So all you got to do is have 1,500 hype points and you'll be able to play in the tournaments. Every other tournament for the rest of the season, unless said otherwise, will be Champions League, which is the new 7,500. So you're getting an extra week to get your points up. But still, 7,500 in the next 2 weeks, or about a week and a half now, is still pretty tough for a lot of per people. So I'm expecting that second cash cup to be quite stacked as far as the quality of players in them. There'll be less players of longer queues, but contenders division, 1500 points in about a week is going to be easy for anyone who is actually going to be able to place in the tournament. So I'm happy Epic made that change. I saw it coming, and I like the fact they're doing this. They're bringing the points down rather than pushing the tournaments further away. But if we just didn't have a preseason, we wouldn't have to worry about that. But again, I've said enough about preseasons. This video, for the most part, I'm keeping it happy and positive. I'll stick to that. So you don't need to be champs division, just 1500 points, and you'll be able to play in this week's cash cups. You guys probably saw my other socials. I'm sorry for missing 2 days uploads and streams. Again, my kidneys is giving me some issues. Don't worry, I'm getting it sorted. I'm not going to go into too much detail. I am fine. Just I need my days off when I need them. So I appreciate your guys' patience, but I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, please chuck a like on it. Let me know in the comment section down below your thoughts on anything I talked about today. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. It would mean the world to me. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one.